Hi, mommies. This is Tanya, Noor's mom. So today I'm going to be speaking to you all about how to transition to cow or buffalo milk for your baby. So, first, what is the right age to move to cow or buffalo milk? So, it is not recommended to start cow or buffalo or any other animal milk for your baby below 1 year of age. Huh? But why? Isn't it healthy? No doubt, cow milk is healthy for your child. It is rich in calcium and vitamin D, which is needed for strong bones. It is rich in protein and carbs. It has vitamin A for your eyes and immunity, vitamin B6, B12 for a healthy nervous system. However, the composition of each of these nutrients in cow milk is not sufficient for babies less than 1 year of age. So, up till 1 year of age, our babies' bodies are growing rapidly. Their organs, their body parts, their motor skills, their brain is developing at very, very fast pace. And for that, it requires proper nutrition and it requires certain nutrients in certain amounts, which is not available in cow or buffalo milk. It is only available in breast milk or formula milk. Also, you know, cow or buffalo milk, it has very, very high amounts of potassium, sodium, calcium, protein, which puts a lot of pressure on a baby's kidney. So, a baby's kidneys are not that mature till 1 year of age. Also, like we know that till 1 year of age, iron is very, very important for our children because it helps in, brain development, cognitive development. It is required for production of blood. It is required for motor skill development. And this iron is not absorbed by the body, baby's body, in the presence of cow milk. Thirdly, so babies require a lot of fat in the first year of their life and even beyond, but first year, till first year is very, very important. And cow milk does not have that amount of fat that babies do require. Lastly, cow milk is majorly made of lactose, and lactose is made up of big molecules that are very, very heavy to digest by the baby. So baby's digestive system is also not that developed till 1 year of age. And whenever we introduce cow milk before 1 year of age, it can cause unnecessary pressure on the digestive system. And in fact, it can lead to problems like constipation and bloating, gas, vomiting, diarrhea. Sometimes the immune system, it might also develop a defensive response. So when we introduce cow buffalo milk before 1 year, as a replacement of formula milk breast milk, there's a very high chance that our system, the immune system starts rejecting it completely. The moment it goes into the body, it shows up some negative consequence. Hence, it is not advised to give cow or buffalo milk to your baby till 1 year of age as a replacement of breast milk or formula milk. Only breast milk or formula milk have the right nutrition in the right composition that your baby requires to develop, to grow in the first year of their life. But after 1 year, when the baby has reached a certain level of development, after that, we can slowly transition our babies from formula milk or breast milk to cow or buffalo milk. Of course, you can continue to breastfeed even longer, even breastfeed till 2 years, 3 years, but you can slowly also start introducing them to cow or buffalo milk as a beverage. Now, after 1 year of age, which is better, cow milk or buffalo milk? So, it is recommended that after 1 year, when you're moving away from breast milk or formula milk, you first start with cow milk as compared to buffalo milk, because cow milk is lighter than buffalo milk. Buffalo milk is heavier, the protein content is higher, the fat content is higher, and the baby's digestive system cannot digest very easily. So it is recommended that you first start with cow milk. But in case you do not want to go with cow milk and directly want to move on your baby to buffalo milk, which you are having in the family, then it is a good idea to thin out the buffalo milk using some water. So now, how do we transition our babies to accepting cow or buffalo milk, to helping their bodies accept cow or buffalo milk easily. So, you know, like I said, from 0 to 6 months, you are not giving any kind of cow milk or buffalo milk to your baby in any form, only breast milk or formula milk. After 6 months, what we move on to is a dairy ladder. So now the dairy ladder means we start introducing cow milk or animal milk in other forms or in small quantities in other forms, so that by the time your baby is 1 year of age and he's at the, you know, age when he will be having that milk as a full meal, a snack, or a replacement to breast milk or formula milk, his body will not have any problem accepting it. So at 6 months, when you start solids for your baby, when you start weaning, you can introduce cow milk in the form of curd, ghee, paneer, or you can even add small amount of milk while making your baby's porridge or your suji ki kheer or any kind of kheer. By 8 to 9 months, then you introduce cheese, which is another form of milk. And then by 1 year of age, you can then move on to cow milk or buffalo milk as a beverage. When we will be exposing our baby's body, his digestive system, to these other forms of lactose from 6 to 12 months, then when we introduce it full-fledgedly at 1 year, our baby's body will not react in a negative manner. Then at 12 months, how do you move on? You know, move to formula, from formula breast milk to cow milk. It's not very difficult. So, you know, till now, babies are used to the taste of breast milk or formula milk. And obviously, if you suddenly, you know, change the baby's milk taste, they will reject it. So please do not do that. What you need to do is, you need to start mixing the two kinds of milk. So even if your baby is on breast milk or formula milk, you have to start the transition in the ratio of 1:3. One part of cow milk to three parts of breast milk or formula milk. So for example, if your baby drinks 8 ounces of milk, formula milk in one go, first week when you're starting, say when the baby is 1 year of age, you mix 2 ounces of cow milk and 6 ounces of formula milk. So 1:3. Then you see if the baby accepts it easily, he has no problem, he doesn't even get to know the taste, then continue this for 1 week. Then the second week, increase it by another 2 ounces. So now 4 ounces of cow milk and 4 ounces of formula milk. So 2:2 ratio. Then again, if baby happily accepts, no problem. Next week, you move on to 6 ounces cow milk and 2 ounces formula milk. And by the fourth week, you can completely move over to cow milk and formula milk goes away. However, if you get stuck in between, say after, you know, the third week, your baby is not accepting full cow milk, it's okay. Continue with that for another couple of weeks and keep on trying. And this is the way you easily transition from formula milk or breast milk to cow milk. So you can even mix breast milk. So express some breast milk and then mix that with cow milk and give it to your baby. And that is exactly what I did. In fact, I had done two things together. So when Noo turned one, I started her transition to cow milk and I started her transition to cup. Basically, I started weaning bottles also together. So by 13 months, I had done both of them in the same way I have described. I have another video on how I weaned Noor's bottles, which you can check out later. Next. What kind of milk should we offer our baby? There are so many varieties available in the market. So like I said, cow milk is preferred more than buffalo milk because it is lighter. Whatever milk you choose, it should not be unpasteurized or raw. Pasteurized should be written clearly on the packet or bottle, because if it is not pasteurized, it can contain bacteria which can cause a lot of problems in baby, which can even have fatal results. Also, the milk that you offer your baby should be full fat, whole milk, full cream milk. So any milk whose fat content is 3 or 3.5% or more. Till 2 years of age, babies should only be having full fat, whole cream milk. And whenever you offer that milk, it should be boiled, so that even if there's any kind of bacteria that's still left, you can get rid of it by boiling it. So now, which milk am I using? So I am using the White Farms cow milk. This is full fat cow milk, A2 cow milk. I think they deliver only in Delhi NCR. So I use them. But you can, check out other brands also like Country Delight. They deliver, I think, in metro cities. And there are some other brands also that deliver this farm fresh milk, A2 cow milk, to your homes. But in case you live in an area where this is not available, or you think that, you do not want to offer this, then normal cow milk is also available in packaged, of the usual brands like Amul and Mother Dairy and Vita and Saras. But even if you don't want to give cow milk and you do decide to give buffalo milk to your baby, like I said, look for full fat whole cream milk. So Amul Gold, that is full cream milk. Then Mother Dairy also has a full cream milk. So basically whatever brand you're using, Amul, Mother Dairy, Gokul, Vita, Saras, just look for full cream or full fat milk. And let me tell you another thing, it is not mandatory to give A2 cow milk only. It's just that A2 cow milk is much more nutritious, but it's not that other cow's milk is not as nutritious. Next, so in what form should we offer this milk to our baby? So number one, when you start milk after 1 year of age, cow milk, it should not be more than 400 to 500 ml a day, around 16 ounces a day, because if the baby drinks more milk, he will not have any appetite left for solids, and then you will start complaining that my baby is not eating. So please restrict it, because cow milk is heavier and baby will feel fuller for longer. And you do not need to add anything in the cow milk before offering to your baby. No sugar, no jaggery, no dates, nothing meetha, no mishri also to be added. Please give your baby plain cow milk. Noor also drinks plain cow milk. Sugar is not recommended for your baby till 2 years of age. It can cause various health issues like diabetes and obesity, cardiovascular diseases later in life. And not just that, there is so much sugar in the market that your babies will be exposed to once they turn 2 or 3 years of age. Avoid sugar, please avoid sugar. Let your baby enjoy the taste of plain milk. Please do not add any kind of Horlicks, Bonvita, Complan. They are full of artificial sugar, artificial sweeteners. They have lots of additives which are not healthy for your baby. Please avoid them. In case you do want to flavor your baby's milk in any way, then try boiling it with some sauf and green elaichi. So boil it for some time. It gives a certain taste which babies might like and accept cow milk. You can also add a little nut powder to the cow milk to make it healthy, and sweeten it with fruits if needed. Make a shake out of it. And in case you still want to sweeten your baby's milk, then dates powder is your best bet. Next. A lot of parents have problems that my baby is not accepting cow milk. So first, try the mixing technique that I've just shared. Second, like I said, flavor it with some fruit, nut powder, boil it with elaichi, sauf. Or it is even okay if your baby does not drink our buffalo milk. It's absolutely okay. Why do we give milk to our babies? Primarily for calcium. So you can give calcium in other forms to your baby, in the form of curd, paneer, cheese, ghee. There's so much calcium in your sesame seeds, white til, ragi, badam, broccoli, spinach, amaranth. All of them are very, very rich in calcium. So you can give those foods. There's nothing to worry about. Lastly, some of the things that you can expect when you start cow milk for your baby as a replacement for formula milk and breast milk after 1 year is that you may notice that your baby's poop or potty color, texture and smell also might change because of the presence of lactose. Secondly, like I said, lactose is heavier to digest, and whenever you introduce, there's a chance that your baby might suffer lactose sensitivity. And he might have problems like constipation or loose motion, vomiting, diarrhea. So this is basically just the system getting adjusted to it. And it should usually get okay in 1 or 2 weeks when the digestive system gets used to lactose. However, if these symptoms persist more than a week or 10 days and they're accompanied by other symptoms like rashes or hives, problem in breathing, swelling of lips and tongue, loss of consciousness, then there can be a chance that your baby might be allergic to milk and he might be lactose intolerant. So in that cases, you should definitely get it checked with your doctor. But the usual constipation and stuff, it will get okay in 1 or 2 weeks. The moment your baby's digestive system gets used to all the lactose. So this is all about how to transition your baby to cow milk. Hope my video was helpful. Keep writing. Take care. Thank you. Bye-bye.